Let's take a look at harmonic split, one of Bitwig's spectral devices. Now, most audio effects work in the amplitude domain, looking the way our waveform does and responding the way a microphone hears the room, with pressure changes being recorded and then reproduced over time. The signal is being treated as a whole. Now, spectral devices think differently. By taking the incoming signal that we just saw and analyzing it into thousands of frequency bands, those individual bands can be used for various kinds of analysis and then regrouped for interesting local effects. And that is the whole purpose of these spectral devices we're looking at in this series, to give you new mix tools by analyzing the sound, finding a musical angle to it, and splitting it up in that dimension. Now, harmonic split's dimension is to start by taking the fundamental of the sound, which means finding it. Now, this can work in a purely amplitude-based effect, like our good friend Tree Monster here, that is analyzing the frequency of the sound coming in, just for the purpose of tracking, tuning an oscillator, and then optionally ring modulating the signal with that oscillator that we are just purely hearing. And there are some analysis parameters here. What's the lowest frequency we should consider for the frequency, for the fundamental, the highest frequency, and even a threshold control for when it should actually engage or not. Now let's try playing chords. And that's when things start getting fun. So harmonic split does this, but in the frequency domain. So we still see the analysis of the fundamental, but then it's breaking the signal into two different channels of harmonics, which we can decide how those channels are being split apart, where the separation is, and a non-harmonic channel as well, for the things that are just far enough outside of the harmonics to land in a different place. That even has a sensitivity control saying we want to be more picky about what goes in here, or less picky and to allow more in. Which, again, in these spectral devices, if less is coming into one channel, that means more is coming into the others before all of the processing takes place. So, simplest processing trick ever, we can turn our clip back on. Could be to take whatever is landing on the odd harmonics and pan them hard left, and whatever's coming in on the evens and pan them hard right. Now we already hear the dancing that you get at times. When different frequencies are present and different things are there. So all these purple parameters are analysis parameters to help us refine that fundamental detection. And organ is fun, I like it. But let's go ahead and take a real world synthesizer type example that's gonna be a little bit more complex to deal with. So our friend Jurgis has some very nice patches here. Perhaps this variant of Power Synth from the Perfect Drift sound package. Now, that's pretty rich. There's a lot going on. This feels like a real world example. The only thing I might do is I hear some reverb and I'm going to turn it off for the time being, because that'll make a different kind of cloud on top of our fundamental detection. So, let's start here. We do see some jumping around, and if we want to hear what we're doing, because that's always helpful in the spectral domain, I'm gonna solo the first band, which is just odds by default, and then I'm saying which harmonics do I want to fall into the first band. And it has a special first position if we go down, which is fundamental only. So this is perfect for trying to refine our tracking and working with these purple parameters. Now, the lowest frequency that could be the fundamental, the highest, these pass filters, this seems okay. We're inside of the range already. I don't think we're having a problem there. So I'm going to leave these alone for the time being. But if I did have issues or wanted to get tricky and misrepresent things, I could drag these around. The tilt parameter, which again is here for analysis, might help us because it lets us rebalance the spectrum by saying the higher frequency should be more important, or what I think I want in this case, the lower frequency should be more important. Because for all of the oscillators stacked up and the layers going on, focusing on the lowest sounds is probably the best place to start for fundamental tracking. And while this automatic threshold mode, it can be good in some instances, in this instance, I think setting a hard threshold might land in a slightly better place. So, that's pretty good. For single notes, that's finding our fundamental pretty well. And remember, even though these are analysis parameters, if things change over time, this is an instrument, I could insert a key track modulator and have it push or pull these values like the threshold a little bit, and it could improve things. But we're in a pretty good place already. And we've already looked a bit at all of these parameters central to the device, including the harmonic split that says, what do you really want on the first channel? And then you'll get the opposite on the second channel. So maybe this is where I want to start. Okay, so what can we do? Well, to make a signal interesting and to give it some brightness, especially when picking a small part of the sound, distortion can always be an interesting type of option, and maybe saturator with its nonlinear warmth could be a little fun here. Even give it a little grit. That's nice. Now for this cluster of other harmonics. So not fifth, not every fifth. Second, third, fourth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, yeah. Something like that. Now they kind of feel like an ensemble already, so I think maybe I'll just play that up in this case. Take a chorus plus, which will give it some stereo-ness to it. And maybe I'll make this a little more intense than I usually would. Give it a little motion, a little dance. Now, in our opening example, we did a hard pan left and right, which worked a bit, but that's not always what I want to do with the sound. In this case, maybe I want to treat these additional harmonics as kind of the sides, which, again, that could lead to a nice friend like the Tool device, which again, for specialized mixing tools, I added some stereo width. There was not much, now there is some. What if I just increase that, make it a bit more extreme? And now I have that kind of ensemble block sitting on the sides more, and the distorted lead sitting on top. Now, again, you could just focus on one of these and just tune them a little bit sound-wise. You don't have to play with all three channels, but since we're looking at them for the first time, the non-harmonic channel. Adding some motion here can be nice, but I already did a chorus on the second channel, so instead of like washing this with a little phaser, maybe I want to use delay plus, but kind of as a big boomy reverb. Let's give it a lot of feedback, a little washout. and even freeze it, because I just had an idea that maybe on release it would be nice for this to hold out a little bit. So let's listen to the audio level coming in and respond quickly and strongly, and pull down the freeze, unfreeze, and pull down the mix when there's a lot of sound, when notes are actively being triggered. And then, when I let go, this will fade out, turn freeze back on, and now there's still a little bit of something occurring, a little atmosphere. Interesting. Well, that's something. That's not too bad. Let's try one other sound example just to take things in a different direction. So I've got audio here, which will, of course, work. Now, with all the default analysis parameters, they can be good sometimes. In this case, let's try our test again. Just hear the fundamental for a moment. That's fine. I'm not interested in playing with the analysis parameters. I just want to try something different. So remember that with these as mix tools that are just focusing on a part of the sound, something that can be nice is doing a normal gesture you would, like a thick reverb. But when it applies to the whole sound in a normal amplitude context, this would be too much. I can push it a little harder because part of the signal is coming here and not all of the signal. So instead of distortion, I'm just going to use a little time wash here, a reverb with convolution, to give it some additional life. And then on the sides, well, we could add anything we want. Maybe it's guitar. I've got a filter. Kind of self-activated ladder with some of its own modulators. So the envelope follower is already opening a little bit. That's kind of fun. Maybe the LFO. Okay. So something with a little bit more life already. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you again soon.